Good morning, students. Everyone, open page number 55. So today we shall start this scene 3. So where we have stopped? Yes, we have stopped that Amy had torn the story books of Joe, and Joe was very much angry on Amy, and when Amy's mother told her to say sorry for Joe, then Amy accepted to say sorry for Joe. So that time, at the evening time, when Joe comes to the dinner table in the kitchen for the tea purpose, that time Amy comes there to say sorry for her. But this Joe, what she does, she did not look to the Amy, and just she went from that room, taking her tea, she went. So next day, scene 3 here, next day this is, Jo is still angry the next day. She can't stand the tension in the house and decides to go ice skating with Lori. Amy runs after her. She wants to apologize and hopes Jo will be in a better mood after skating. At the river, Jo sees her coming and turns her back and ignoring her. So next day, Jo is very much angry. Still, she is angry because her storybook has been burned by this Amy. So her mood is off. So what she does? She went out of her house to play the skating. So to relax herself, she went. So Amy, she is there to Joe. At that time, what she thinks, after this skating, Joe will be in a good mood. So that time, I can apologize her. I can say sorry for her, she decides. So at the river, there also, Joe sees Amy, but she ignores her. She did not give any response and she went. So here they are told, for after skating at the river. So you can see here, river is there. River is full of ice. It is full of ice and you can play skating on this. So here, Joe to Lori, is ice thick enough for skating? Joe is asking to Lori, her friend. She asks whether the river is full of ice, whether it is thick or no for skating, it is comfortable or not. She is asking, Lori, it isn't safe in the middle, keep near the shore, come let's race. So what this Lori told her? Lori told her it is not safe in the middle. In the middle of the river, it is not safe. There is a water, enough ice is there. There is a water, so you keep shore. What he told, keep near the shore. Keep near the shore means at the border. You can play at the border. So what he is saying, come let's race. What narrative race will you see? Joe and Larry skate away, zigzagging down the river. Amy is struggling to put her skates on and has not heard Lori's warning about the ice. So then she is listening. Amy is listening there. So both of them are playing there on the ice, zigzagging. So Amy is struggling to put her skates on and has not heard Lori's warning about the ice. So what Lori was saying to Joe, that in the middle of the ice, the place is not safe. He told, but Amy did not listen that. She was putting that skating. She was engaged in that. Lori soon vanishes around the bend of the river. Joe is just about to turn when she sees Amy skating towards the middle of the river. All at once, there is a crash of ice, a splash of water and a cry, as Amy throws up her hands and goes down. So afterwards, Laurie, what she did? Laurie, he turned and he went zigzagging. He went on the ice. So Joe was also about to turn. She was also following this Laurie. So she was also going there. But at suddenly, what she listens? She listens a crash. That is, she listens a sound. Amy is sitting towards the middle of the river. All at once, there is a crash of ice, a splash of water, and a cry as Amy throws up her hands and goes down. So Amy did not listen. At the middle of the river, there was an unsafe. So she went there only and she fell down there. You can see her. She has fallen down here, the middle of the river. And she is crying. She started crying. She throws up her arms. Her hands. She throws up her hands and goes down. So what she is like this is making, and she is crying in that water. Joe tries to rush forward, but her feet seem to have no strength in them. For a second, she stands motionless. She stares at the middle blue hood above the water with fear in her heart. Larry rushes swiftly past her towards the crack in the ice. So when Joe saw this, she followed in the enemy. She was very much shocked by seeing this. She could not tell anything. She could not speak, and she stood like that only. There only she stood like that only at that time. Soon who came there? Laurie came there. Laurie came near that enemy. Laurie is saying to Joe, bring a pole quick. So what he is telling? Bring a pole. This wooden pole will be there now. So Laurie told to Joe to bring the pole soon, so that one end of the pole will hold the enemy and under will hold this. Laurie will hold that pole and then she can come out. Laurie is calm as he lies on the ice and holds enemy firmly by the arm. Joe drags a long pole from a fence nearby and holds it out to Amy. Together she and Laurie get the child out. They carry her back home. So we can see here. Laurie came here, and this is Amy. This is Joe. She is bringing the pole, and Laurie is holding her hand and she is pulling out. Okay, afterwards she brought the pole and gave it to Laurie. Laurie gave that pole to the Amy, and Joe and Laurie both, they brought this Amy out of the water. Now she is out of the danger now. Yes, now scene 4. So this much it happened here. Later in the evening, Amy lies fast asleep, rolled up in the warm blankets before a fire. Joe is pale and quiet as she watches Amy sleep. So Amy, they took Amy to the home. She has very kept warm there. They were rolled up in a warm blankets they have put on her, and she is sitting before the fire. Amy is sitting before the fire here. So next we will see tomorrow's sun.